promise me this, that you'll stand by me forever. But if God forbid fate should step in and force us into a goodbye, if you have children someday,
I was younger. The fat kid with the big blue eyes full of wonder. No shame, no fame, no worries. The king of wiffle ball. Without a care at all. I wish I was younger. Keeping track of the lightning strikes and the thunder. Barely 13, no hurry, my feet over the wall. Doesn't matter if I fall. I wish I was younger. I wish I was younger. Barbies and fashion shows with my brother. So clear, no fear, no bullies, I didn't even know. Where did all that magic go? I remember third grade,
shades,
new rollerblades, 4 foot two, feeling 10 foot eight,
classic Mario.
I remember charades,
your phrase,
my first date, working at the pool, barely ever getting paid. Do you remember those days?
I wish I was younger.
Start to fall. I really need somebody to call my own. somebody to someone.
And if the sun starts setting, the sky goes cold, and if the clouds get heavy and start to fall, I really need somebody to call my own. I wanna be somebody to someone. Someone to you. Someone to you. Someone to you. Someone to you. Someone to you.
Lines flying. Lifted in a haze, we were just a phase, we were just pretend. I remember the low lows and highs. We threw our hands up, palms out to the sky.
It was fun when we were young and now we're older. Those days when we were broke in California.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong, and what's small turn to a friendship, a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone.
can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last time.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again. Someday, when they point to the
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remain standing until the graduates have been seated.
Did all of them?
Good evening. On behalf of Mr. Tom Stollard and the remaining Board of Trustees, it is my privilege to welcome you to Holy Trinity's Class of 2020 graduation ceremony. I am Catherine Cobb, and I am privileged to be the president of Holy Trinity Academy. And we're so grateful to finally be together to have this well-deserved celebration for our students. It is our hope that tonight's ceremony is a chance for graduates, faculty, trustees, family, and friends to take a deep breath from the challenges of the world around us and cherish this moment and this rite of passage for our students and our school community. The love and respect these seniors have for each other and for the greater Holy Trinity community and beyond can serve as a wonderful example for all of those around them. We are so glad each and every one of you are here for this moment, and we're very appreciative of our hosts, the DeDonatis family, and the USSSA Space Coast Stadium for sharing this beautiful facility. Will you please stand for the invocation given by Ms. Sarah Kimmerling?
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, you create life from the earth on which we dwell and breathe into it new life and meaning. Graciously, you empower us with knowledge and skills to aid one another as we live out our life on this earth. Bless our gathering this evening as we recall your grace and kindness to graduates and celebrate the endings and beginnings of the opportunities you provide. Empower us all to live lives worthy of the callings you offer, that we may strengthen one another and your creation as we walk together with you through this life. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If you aren't already, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Good evening. Please be seated. On behalf of my peers in the class of 2020, thank you to all the families, friends, and special guests in attendance. None of us imagined we would finish our time at Holy Trinity this way, but even though we sit far apart, we are connected by our shared HT experiences and our excitement for our next journeys. Thank you for your patience, guidance, love, and all the sacrifices you made to bring us to this moment. And thank you for being here to celebrate with us. Without further ado, welcome to the commencement ceremony for Holy Trinity Episcopal Academy's Class of 2020.
Hello, my name is Quan Nguyen. I'm an international student from Vietnam, and this is my fifth year at Holy Trinity. I would like to welcome everyone, especially families who traveled here to attend our class of 2020 graduation. I hope you all have a wonderful time throughout your stay. Thank you very much for celebrating with us. Chào mọi người, em là Đức Quân. Thay mặt toàn thể học sinh lớp 12 và trường Holy Trinity, xin gửi tất cả mọi người, đặc biệt là những bậc phụ huynh đã từ xa đến tham dự lễ tốt nghiệp của khóa 2020. Lời chào và cảm nhận trong trận nhóm.
Because we are blending our baccalaureate and graduation ceremonies, we will now have readings from Scripture. A reading from Deuteronomy 31, verses 7 through 8. Then Moses summoned Joshua and said to him in the light of all Israel, "Be strong and courageous, for you shall go with this people into the land that the Lord has sworn to their fathers to give to them. And you shall put them in possession of it. It is in the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed." The word of the Lord.
A reading from Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God will help her when morning dawns. The nations rage, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord, how he has brought desolations on the earth. He makes war cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I'll be exalted among the nations. I'll be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. The word of the Lord.
A reading from John 16, 26 through 28 and 31 through 33. In that day you will ask in my name, and I do not say to you that I will ask the Father on your behalf. For the Father himself loves you, because you have loved me and have believed that I came from God. I came from the Father and have come into the world, and now I am leaving the world and going to the Father. Jesus answered them,
Do you now believe? Behold, the hour is coming, indeed it has come, when you will be scattered, each to his own home, and will leave me alone. Yet I am not alone, for the Father is with me. I have said these things to you, that in my heart you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I will have overcome the world. The word of the Lord.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for being here to celebrate the HT Class of 2020. I'm Anjani Apasingha, and I'm so glad I was given the opportunity to introduce the graduating Class of 2020 salutatorian. The honor of a salutatorian is given to the student who has achieved the second highest GPA in our graduating class. And this year, that is Rhea Cho, who also happens to be one of my best friends. Tonight, Rhea is being recognized for outstanding academic achievements. And if any of you know Rhea, you know that she's the most humble person in this world. So I had to do my research to figure out everything she had accomplished. I would like to start off by saying that her academic achievements aren't the only thing that made her our salutatorian. Rhea is always working to help others. She's constantly volunteering and tutoring and just being the best person she can be. And I'm so happy that she is being recognized for all that she has accomplished. I've known Rhea since freshman year, and she's been nothing but kind, loyal, and considerate. Everything that we as a class could ever want in a salutatorian. Rhea is not only academically gifted, but also an astounding artist and musician. I would like to highlight some of Rhea's achievements during her time at HT. She's a recipient of the National Merit Scholarship. Her artwork was published 4 times in Celebrating Art Anthology. She's a MathWorks Math Modeling National Scholarship recipient and received a perfect score at the Florida State Spanish Competition. With all that she's accomplished, she's remained the same humble, kind-hearted friend who I first met in 9th grade. I'm so glad to be given this time to talk about Rhea and can't wait to see what more amazing heights she will reach at the prestigious Rice University. I can't think of another person who deserves to be this year's salutatorian because Rhea Cho has it all. Everyone, give a warm welcome to our Class of 2020 salutatorian, Rhea Cho!
Thank you so much, Anjani. I'm humbled by your beautiful introduction. Good evening, Holy Trinity family, friends, faculty, administrators, and of course, my fellow Class of 2020 seniors. Words cannot describe how grateful I am that we are gathered here in person today and not graduating over a Zoom video call. Before I share my message, I would like to take a moment to thank the parents, family members, teachers, and school administrators who have made this graduation ceremony possible in spite of our challenging circumstances and have come to celebrate the accomplishments of the Class of 2020. Let's give a round of applause to all of us. As I was thinking of what I would share today, I was reminded of an analogy Mrs. Mariani made this year in her AP English language class. I would like to thank Mrs. Mariani for allowing me to use her wonderful analogy in this speech. Today, I would like to talk about sheep and llamas. You might be thinking of two cute furry animals, one with a significantly longer neck than the other,
Maybe you prefer llamas over sheep, or sheep over llamas, or you might not have a preference. I hope I can leave you convinced by the end of this message that, figuratively speaking, we should all strive to be llamas instead of sheep. To better understand these two fluffy mammals, we have to be aware of their behavioral patterns. Sheep, by nature, possess a flock mentality. They move in herds and are born with a behavioral tendency to follow the sheep in front of them. The actions of one sheep can influence the actions of the entire herd, even if those actions are senseless. For instance, in 2005, a flock of 1,500 sheep fell off a cliff in Turkey after one sheep made the first jump. While this is a dramatic example, I think it sheds light on the poor decision-making that results from the inability to think for oneself. Llamas, on the other hand, possess a few key behaviors that distinguish them from sheep. Physically, they have much longer necks than sheep, allowing them to have greater perspective. Behaviorally, they are much more intelligent, inquisitive, and persistent. Like sheep, llamas are incredibly social creatures, but they also assert their own independence by marking their own territories and making their own decisions. When faced with an uncomfortable or frightful situation, we, like sheep, can find ourselves following the herd without critically analyzing our own reasoning. On a smaller scale, we might decide to handle our social insecurities at the age of 10 by mimicking the way our peers behave and dress in place of proactively confronting the heart of the issue, our own confidence. Or we might decide to choose to take the electives our peers are taking, not because we're interested in them, but because our friends are. On a bigger scale, we might pick a career path not because it best fits our goals and aligns with our personal values, but because others have traveled the same road and we are simply ignorant of other pathways. I'm not here to say that it's bad to follow the herd. In fact, in many cases, the wisdom of the crowd can be an incredible source of inspiration for how we should spend our time and energy. However, failing to think for ourselves can be dangerous. Like llamas, we should establish our own independence by constantly analyzing our choices. We should look towards empirical evidence and thoroughly analyze our options to make well-informed and not fear-driven or peer-driven decisions. Our Holy Trinity education has taught us to be conscientious young adults who uphold the principles of integrity and commitment in all of our pursuits. We're inspired by people such as Chaplain Jared to take the time and effort to make meaningful connections with others, by Mr. Rentier to understand instead of blindly memorize what we see, by Mr. McGinnis to adapt quickly in new and unfamiliar situations, by Ms. Saylor to maintain a positive outlook when confronted with seemingly daunting tasks, by Mr. Chiarella to commit to the principles of excellence, diligence, and honesty in both our academic and personal lives, by Mr. Bonanza to critically assess any sort of data we come across and pursue independent academic exploration, by Mr. Lovelace to approach life with curiosity, by Dr. Cobb to lead with both spirit and realistic optimism, and by many, many other HET teachers and staff who have taught us to possess the enthusiasm of a novice and the discipline of a master in the pursuit of any goal. Our Holy Trinity family has continuously inspired us to critically think for ourselves and act proactively in all spheres of our lives. But Holy Trinity doesn't mold us into llamas just to feel special about ourselves. No, the HD community teaches us to adopt humility and empathy to fulfill a greater purpose. The class of 2020 has already seen a fair amount of success, and I'm absolutely amazed by the incredible array of interests and passions demonstrated by my classmates. From soccer to acting and art to Latin, we all possess our own special interests and have the potential to manifest positive changes in unique ways. There is no doubt that the world will be significantly different after this pandemic and the current political climate.
in a world of misinformation, ignorance, confused political leaders and health officials, and unstable economies, we'll need many llamas to employ their unique strengths to mend our weaknesses, introduce new solutions, and point us back in the right direction. Whether we're going to college, serving in the military, or taking a gap year, I hope we can all catch those moments when we're tempted to blindly follow the herd by critically analyzing our own rationale and reminding ourselves to stay llamas. Thank you so much.
Good evening. I would like to take a moment in our ceremony tonight to recognize our alumni. The class of 2020 is Holy Trinity's 18th graduating class. As the 103 students graduate today, our high school alumni total will reach 1,471, three of these being my own sisters. In fact, our own class of 2020 has 27 sibling alumni, many of whom are with us tonight to celebrate this milestone with their families. We would like to welcome them and ask that all alumni in attendance please stand to be recognized. In keeping with tradition, we welcome back one of our own as the commencement speaker for the class of 2020. This year's speaker graduated from Holy Trinity Episcopal Academy in 2010 and was chosen by the senior class to address the class of 2020. I will now turn it over to Jacob Togshaw to introduce our keynote speaker.
Before I introduce our guest speaker, I want to take a moment to thank you all to come celebrate with us, but to also congratulate my fellow graduates. This senior class has been through a lot this year, and I'm so proud of every single one of you. I'm so glad we have the opportunity to celebrate our accomplishments together. As Lauren shared with you, our next speaker was part of Holy Trinity's graduating class of 2010. He received a Bachelor of Arts degree in International Business from San Diego State University in 2015, and has since lived and worked in seven different countries. He currently lives in Austin, Texas, where he works as a digital marketing specialist for political campaigns and advocacy groups across the United States. While a student at Holy Trinity, Patrick was a standout baseball player, so it's quite fitting that he returned to speak to us from a baseball diamond. So please join me in welcoming Mr. Patrick Hamilton.
Thank you, Jacob. I would like to start by congratulating the class of 2020. You've reached an outstanding milestone in your life and should be very proud of all the hard work it took to get to this point. I feel so honored to get the chance to speak tonight, and I hope that what I'm about to say can offer you some value for life after high school. When I was asked to give tonight's commencement speech, I was shocked. I thought to myself, why me? What could I possibly say to the graduating class about life when I'm still trying to figure out life for myself? I thought more about it, and I saw there was a deeper message within my own experience that could be worth sharing. Writing this speech brought me back to my days at Holy Trinity. I was one of the few who attended Holy Trinity from K-3 through 12th grade. It's where I grew up. It's where I made lifelong friendships. It's where I learned right from wrong. It's where I learned how to become a leader. But my biggest takeaway from Holy Trinity was curiosity. There are two teachers here who inspired curiosity in their students more than anyone else, and that is Mr. Trella and Mr. Lovelace. Anyone who has taken one of their classes knows just how passionate and dedicated they are to not only the subject matter, but to their students. Both of them have a unique ability to communicate a complex topic like microbiology or cosmology and generate genuine interest in the subject. Unfortunately, this was their last year teaching at Holy Trinity, but I want to thank you both for all you've done for the students and faculty over the years. So, with all of this curiosity that I accumulated in high school, when I was in your spot 10 years ago, sitting here for graduation, I had no idea what I wanted to do. However, what I did know is that I wanted to experience something new and see something different. With the support of my family, I chose to attend college on the other side of the country at San Diego State University. And as all of you will soon experience, moving away from home for the first time, it's a real wake-up call. You will quickly begin to appreciate all the times your parents cooked your dinner or did your laundry. But more importantly, you'll begin to start thinking for yourself and making up your own mind about the world around you. I became infatuated with this experience of being in a completely new place, so far away from home. And I made a decision to study international business with the hopes of working abroad when I would graduate. Now, I had a couple of internships abroad while I was majoring in college, but I never could have predicted the experience that I was about to have. Through a connection I made with a Chinese student here at Holy Trinity, actually, I was fortunate enough to get a job selling office partitions with a company located in Hangzhou, China. Now, I'm going to be honest, I was scared to take that leap. I didn't know anything about the country, I didn't know the language, I didn't know anyone there. I remember the first day when I got there, I went to go find some food. Simple enough. I walked into a small restaurant, and everyone immediately stopped eating and started staring at me. I walked up to the counter, and there was a little boy, maybe he was 10 years old, and he just was staring at me with a blank stare. I tried my best to order something from the menu, but I got no response at all. I didn't know what to do, and eventually I walked out of the restaurant feeling completely embarrassed and defeated. I knew right then and there that I needed to adapt, and fast. I started to do all that I could to learn the language, understand the culture, and meet the people. Because ultimately, I can never expect people to understand me if I didn't understand them. 8 months soon passed by, and I was feeling very comfortable living in the country. I got an unexpected call from my boss, and he told me that he would like me to move to the Middle East to help expand the company's market presence in the region. Of course, I said I would go, and once again, I would be faced with another opportunity to push the boundaries of my comfort zone. Interestingly enough, the transition working in the Middle East came much easier for me, and our company was seeing a lot of success. We were getting new projects all over the place, from Kuwait to the UAE, to India, to Ethiopia. However, this experience also came with its moments of doubts. 3 years ago to this day, actually, I found myself in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, during Ramadan. And for those who don't know, Ramadan is an Islamic holiday. And in Saudi Arabia, it's illegal to consume food or drinks in public during the day. I found myself walking the streets of Riyadh in June in 120-degree heat, unable to drink water, looking for business when most businesses were closed. I remember thinking to myself, this is the last place in the world that I want to be right now. It wasn't until I came back to the United States that I started to see the value in all the good and bad experiences that I had. I met some of the most genuine people in the world, and also some of the meanest. I met people who loved that I was American, and others who hated me for it. I learned about other belief systems and ways of living life, some good, some bad. The overall experience shattered my preconceived notions of how the world is or how it should be. I could have never anticipated where my initial desire to see something new would eventually take me, but it opened my mind to the possibilities of the world. The most important thing that I learned in my years abroad was the power of empathy and embracing different perspectives and opinions. If you understand that people are conditioned from the moment they're born by the world around them, it's much easier to put yourself in their shoes and see their perspective. By the way 2020 has been going, it seems that this might be the hardest thing for human beings to do. Now, although Melbourne is a great place to grow up, and Holy Trinity is an excellent school to attend, there's still so much more out in the world for you to see and learn about. As you start the next phase of your life, you're going to meet people who see the world completely different than you. Maybe if they're from a different country, you've already experienced that. Maybe they have a different religious belief. That's okay. Embrace it. At the end of the day, we're all people on this planet who share much more in common with each other than not. Our world is getting smaller and more connected by the day, and we need leaders and problem solvers who can work well with others, especially if they have different opinions and beliefs. With the values, skills, and knowledge instilled at you at Holy Trinity, all of you are more prepared than most to become leaders in our communities and do wonders wherever you go in the world. I hope that wherever you do go in the world, that you follow your passions and keep an open mind. Some of you might know exactly what it is that you want to do, and that's great. Some of you might be like me and not know exactly what it is that you want to do, and that's great too. The universe has a way of working itself out, and while it's important to plan ahead, it's equally as important to embrace the moment that you're in. Take it from me, life moves extremely quick, and before you know it, you'll be celebrating your 10-year reunion. When you leave here tonight, I also encourage you to leave your comfort zone. Don't be afraid to fail or embarrass yourself ordering food at a restaurant. These are the moments where we can learn the most and when real change occurs inside of us. Challenge yourself, your beliefs, and push the boundaries of what you think you're capable of doing. I guarantee you that you'll surprise yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hamilton, for your words. Our school is blessed to be represented by such fine alumni such as yourself, who represent our core values. In acknowledgement of your contributions to our community, both as a student and a Holy Trinity alumnus, we would like to present you an honorary peace award, recognizing your respect for others, spirit of cooperation, and honorable decision-making in all areas of your life. Thank you. At this time, please enjoy a performance by Adia McDougal. Please direct your attention to the Jumbotron.
Choice to sit it out or dance. I hope you dance. a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some heavy heart leave you bitter. When you feel like selling up, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. When you get the choice to sit it out.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Charlotte Barnes, and I have been chosen to introduce the Class of 2020 Valedictorian. The title of Valedictorian is awarded to the student with the highest grade point average in the graduating class. This year, our Valedictorian is Isha Patel. I can think of no one more deserving of this title. From pushing through AP Biology as a freshman, to being one of only 13 students in the whole state of Florida to achieve the highest score of a 5 on the 2019 AP Latin exam, to eventually completing 15 AP courses, it is no secret that Isha is brilliant and an extremely hard worker. She is also just as accomplished and dedicated outside of the classroom. She has choreographed dances for India Fest, worked at a restaurant, served as president of National Honor Society, and won awards for her acting abilities. These diverse experiences have shaped her into a wonderful, understanding friend and leader. I first met Isha in seventh grade, and we've been close friends ever since. Many know us as the girls who are weirdly enthusiastic about Latin, due to serving as officers of the statewide classics organization, the Florida Junior Classical League. Through unique experiences like singing a parody of Party in the USA in front of over 1,000 people and leading cheers in Winnie the Pooh and Piglet onesies, our time in the FJCL has made us closer friends and taken us out of our comfort zone on numerous occasions. It was a privilege getting to work with her, grow as leaders, and improve the organization during our 2 years together as officers. Altogether, Isha is just a wonderful person and friend. She is a great listener, considerate of others' feelings, and is always willing to help. Being around her makes you simply want to work harder and be better. Duke is getting not only an amazing student, but also a kind, thoughtful person. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Holy Trinity's 2020 valedictorian, Isha Patel.
faculty, family, friends, and of course, the class of 2020, welcome. I honestly can't believe we made it here. Up until a few weeks ago, I imagined I would be giving this speech on the stage of the Scott Center, looking out at the pews filled to their maximum capacity. But rather, I am addressing you now in this huge stadium where we are all awkwardly spread out in efforts to social distance. However, this was not the only big change we've experienced during our time at Holy Trinity. Aside from the recent change in day-to-day schedules and the dramatic difference in Matthew Williams' hairstyle, so much else has changed since we began here as students, some as seventh graders, some as freshmen, some even as preschoolers. From struggling through tests and homework assignments to absorbing wisdom in the classroom, we now have to say goodbye to Mr. Chiarella, Mr. Lovelace, Mr. Bonanza, Mrs. Stroop, Madame Doucet, and Mrs. Peters, some of the most influential teachers we've ever had. From walking down the halls in the same attire as everyone around us every single day, to now never again having to put on that uniform, to never getting yelled at to tuck in your shirt by Mrs. Reed while rushing to your next class. While a lot has changed since we ended our senior year, it seems our high school experience has many parallels to the coronavirus pandemic. Think back to when this coronavirus mess first began. No one, not government officials, nor healthcare experts, not even our president, knew how to properly respond to the incoming threat and handle the situation. Similarly, in our freshman year, we often didn't know what was going on, both academically and socially. Take, for example, Angelina Berthume's iconic response to a homecoming proposal. If you know, you know. Even though many of us hadn't moved campuses, that transition from the 800 building to the halls of the official high school was monumental. Homework came in large heaps instead of small piles, time management was becoming an increasingly prominent issue, and friend groups were growing and changing. However, by sophomore year, we started to get a handle on things. Just as in terms of the pandemic, the country began to enact stay-at-home orders, close businesses, and create math models to project COVID-19 cases. In school, we had now moved on from bio to chem, an unforgettable class with the famous Mrs. Irvin. We also traded in books such as To Kill a Mockingbird and Of Mice and Men for 30-page research articles in our struggle through projects and presentations in AP seminar. There were some notable moments that year involving things like Spirit Week outfits, hoverboards, and magic carpets. As sophomore year came to an end, things became more serious with the onset of junior year. Likewise, coming back to the comparison with the pandemic, we were now in the dead center of quarantine. Everyone was miserable at home, seeing very little hope, just as many of us did junior year between SAT ACT testing, weekly A-push quizzes, and a seemingly endless number of Honor Society meetings. Transitioning into senior year, much of this stress carried over into college applications as we frantically tried meeting deadlines, writing essays, and sending transcripts. As quarantine continued into an unbearable length of time, after everyone became bored of baking, painting, working out, and even TikToking like me, it seems that a lot of us became rebellious and started hanging out with friends again. This kind of mirrors the beginning of our senior year. No one was older than us now. We, and not any of the underclassmen, were the only ones on campus in out of uniform on select Thursdays. We now had those senior privileges. In fact, some of us even accidentally wore college shirts to school one day instead of uniforms, causing chaos and panic throughout the entire day. Now, the end of our senior year can't fit into a description or metaphor. It was unlike anything anyone has ever experienced before. And rather than look at everything we missed out on, we can look at this in terms of how unique our class is. Who else can say that they graduated in the middle of a pandemic? Despite all of the odds and obstacles placed before us, we made it here today. Of course, This would not have been possible without all of the help and support we received along the way. To our teachers, who oftentimes went above and beyond to make sure we were headed in the right direction, thank you for being role models and great mentors throughout our time here. And to our families, thank you for being there every step of the way and truly providing the strength we needed to make it thus far. I personally want to thank my mom and dad for inspiring me to become a better person every day and showing me there is never a goal that is impossible to achieve. I want to thank my sister and the rest of my family as well for supporting me in all sorts of ways, even when I didn't realize it. I would especially like to thank my gurus, Pramukh Swami Maharaj and Mahant Swami Maharaj, who gave me the Shraddha, or faith, and Himmat, or courage, to stand where I am today. In fact, I'd like to end with a quote from Pramukh Swami Maharaj. In my mother tongue, Gujarati, it goes, Bijana bhala ma apnu bhalu, which translates to, in the joy of others lies our own. It's hard to stay positive in this world full of negativity right now, but if there's one thing we've learned from the situation, it's that life is bigger than grad bash, than the last day of high school, or even than graduation. We should look at this situation not by what we've lost, but we should see it as an opportunity to better ourselves and to help better others. As Pramukh Swami Maharaj said, we should find joy in helping others, which couldn't be any more true than during a time like this. So, to my peers, go out into the world and find a way to make your impact on others. Helping even just one person will make the world a better place and will help you find your happiness. Congratulations, class of 2020, and best of luck in all of your future endeavors.
Dr. Cobb and members of the Board of Trustees, I have the honor to present to you the graduating class of 2020. Will the candidates please rise?
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority vested in me, I do hereby confer upon you this high school diploma, certifying that you have met the requirements of scholarship and service as prescribed for graduation by the Board of Trustees of Holy Trinity Episcopal Academy. Congratulations. Graduates, as your name is called, please come forward to accept your diploma, and we ask that your family stand when it is your turn.
Kayla Marie Burge.
Kayla will be attending the University of Florida.
James Stephen Dandridge.
Yes. Jamie will be attending Auburn University.
John Michael Dandridge.
John Michael will be attending Auburn University.
Zachary Paul Joshua Ingram.
Zach will be attending Florida State University.
Caroline Grace Lehman.
Caroline will be attending the University of Mississippi.
Alex James Miles, STEAM Diploma.
Alex will be attending the University of Alabama.
Michael E. Tomadakis.
Michael will be attending the University of Florida.
Congratulations. Seth Nolan Tracy.
Nolan will be attending the University of North Florida.
Charlotte Eva Varnes, AP Capstone and Global Citizenship Diploma.
Charlotte will be attending Northwestern University.
Catherine Elizabeth Patrice Welch.
Catherine will be attending Florida State University.
Matthew Robert Williams.
Matthew will be attending the University of Florida.
Isabel Marina Chicciolo, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Isabel will be attending the University of North Florida.
Isaac Allen Oakley.
Isaac will be attending Eastern Florida State College.
Brandon Noah Assam.
Brandon will be attending the University of Miami.
Jacob Keith Cogshall.
Jacob will be attending DePaul University.
Samuel Bodie Cohen.
Bodie will be attending Auburn University.
Sarah Isabel Kimmerling, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Sarah will be attending Florida State University.
Rahul Persana.
Rahul will be attending the University of Florida.
Alexandra Frances Swiger.
Alex will be attending the Ringling College of Art and Design.
Brett Ethan Braddock.
Brett will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Christopher York Selby, Jr.
Chris will be attending the University of South Carolina.
Jack Burton Wadsworth.
Jack will be attending Auburn University.
Miles Kendrick Chapman.
Miles will be attending Florida A&M University.
Timothy Lance Nunu Jr.
Tim will be attending the University of Florida.
Grant Alexander Thorpe, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Grant will be attending the University of North Florida.
Carmen Louisa Zip.
Carmen will be attending the United States Coast Guard Academy and playing on their volleyball team.
Marissa Ann Spies, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Marissa will be attending Emory University as a member of their swim team.
Aaron Mary Bonet.
Aaron will be attending the University of Florida.
Ryan Alex Mosier. Yeah.
Ryan will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Isha Vishnu Patel, AP Capstone, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Isha will be attending Duke University.
Amelia Teresa Anella.
Amelia will be attending the University of Southern California.
Morgan Marie Bierbrunner.
Morgan will be attending the University of Tampa.
Adam Gregory Cole.
Adam will be attending Florida State University.
Haley Megan Dunn.
Haley will be attending Queen's University of Charlotte to play on their soccer team.
Lauren Donata Stallone Gales.
Lauren will be attending Vanderbilt University.
Trenton Treville Gowans.
Trenton will be attending Tallahassee Community College.
Jackson Connor Heitmeister.
Jackson will be attending the University of South Florida.
Annalise Lopez.
Anaya will attend the University of Central Florida.
Edward Raphael Marr.
Eddie will be attending the University of Miami.
Layla Grimple Matthews. Global Citizenship Diploma.
Layla will be attending Florida State University.
Adia Brianna McDougall, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Adia will be attending the University of North Florida.
Emily Elizabeth McGowan.
Emily will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Elizabeth Lauren McKee.
Liz will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Colin Patrick McLaughlin, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Colin plans to attend the University of Virginia.
Bradley James Means.
Brad will be attending Florida State University.
Heather May Motro, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Heather will be attending Clemson University.
Molly Isabel Callie Newland.
Molly will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Sophia Michelle Obermeyer.
Sophia will be serving on a gap year with the World Race.
Nicholas Abiyami Olumiu.
Nick will be attending Duke University.
Kevin Joseph Platt.
Kevin will be attending Tulsa Welding College.
Grace Porter.
Lauren will be attending the University of Florida.
Honoré Leon. 1 pound.
Honoré will be attending Spring Hill College as a member of the track and field team.
Xavier Curtis Robertson.
Xavier will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Yeah. Carson Jack Schweitzer.
Carson will be attending the University of Miami.
Jack Logan Spedicini, AP Capstone, STEAM Diploma.
Jack will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Chelsea Olivia Terry.
Chelsea will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Jake Michael Vigent, AP Capstone Diploma.
Jake will be attending Duke University.
Cecilia Riley Whitfield.
Riley will be attending the University of Tampa.
Marissa Belize, AP Capstone Diploma.
Marissa will be attending the University of South Florida.
Charles Edwin Cacciatore.
Chaz will be attending Florida Atlantic University.
Rhea Cho.
Rhea will be attending Rice University.
Haley Simone Ford.
Haley will be attending Florida Atlantic University.
Danielle Dorothy Fries.
Danielle will be attending the University of Miami.
Christian Patrick Green.
Christian will be attending the University of North Carolina, Wilmington.
Nicholas Thomas Green.
Nick will be attending Stetson University.
Latorius Hill Jr.
Larry will be attending Polk State College.
Juan Nguyen, STEAM Diploma.
Juan will be attending the University of Florida.
Ajale Lauren Riviera.
Ajale was not able to attend tonight, and she will be attending Eastern Florida State College in the fall.
Brooks Arthur Taylor.
Brooks will be attending High Point University.
Harrison Andrew Tinker.
Harrison is going to attend Trinity University.
Angelina Marie Berthume.
Angelina will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Jordan Elizabeth Blair.
Jordan will attend Lesley University, where she is signed to play basketball. Thank you.
Anjane Diana Epensingha, STEAM and AP Capstone Diploma.
Anjane will be attending Virginia Tech.
Pedro Antonio Gonzalez, Jr.
Pedro will be attending Florida A&M University and will be playing baseball.
Matthew Jordan Johnson.
Matt will be attending Eastern Florida State College.
Julia Elizabeth McCarthy, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Yeah. Julia will be attending Florida Atlantic University.
Ada Marie McClatchy.
Ada will be attending the University of Tampa.
Emily Raylan No, AP Capstone Diploma.
Emily will attend the University of Tampa where she will play volleyball.
Trey Anthony Palmer. Tyler William Ridson, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Tyler will be attending Elon University.
Priya J. Westerman.
Priya will be attending the University of North Florida.
Hu-Ya Young.
Leo was not able to attend tonight, but will be attending the University of Washington, Seattle in the fall.
Javaris Ramon Johnson.
Javaris will be attending Hiram University in Ohio and will be playing basketball.
Caroline Elizabeth Kelly, Global Citizenship Diploma.
Caroline will be attending Villanova University. Angelia was not able to attend tonight, but in the fall she will be attending the University of North of California, Irvine.
Owen Broderick McGinty.
Owen will be attending Tallahassee Community College.
Shelby Brooke Siege.
Shelby will be attending the Wentworth Institute of Technology, where she will be a member of the volleyball team. Tom was not able to attend tonight, but in the fall will attend Indiana University, Bloomington.
Jason Marco Vizai.
Jason will be attending the University of Florida.
Peyton Aubrey Yates.
Peyton will be attending the University of North Alabama, where she will be a member of the soccer team.
Joseph Lee Blackstrain.
Joe will be attending Jacksonville State University.
Lucas Dutra.
Dutra will be attending Valencia College.
Antoine Michael Freeman Jr.
Antoine will be attending Spring Hill College, where he will be a member of the track and field program.
Devarian Alicia Marvin.
Dee will be attending Spring Hill College and be a part of the track and field program.
Emmanuel Mark Nifakos.
Mark will be attending the University of Central Florida.
Congratulations. Jeremiah Davion Odene.
Jeremiah will be serving in the United States Navy.
Ryan Leo Quinn.
Ryan will be attending Florida Gulf Coast University.
Congratulations, Ryan. Peyton McKenna Simpson.
Peyton will be attending Florida State University.
Wong Hao Shin.
Harrison was not able to attend tonight, but will attend University of Connecticut in the fall.
Jackson Raphael Mariani, AP Capstone Global Citizenship Diploma.
Jackson will be attending New York University.
Raphael Wong.
Raph will attend the University of Sydney.
Kevin Lamar Chandler.
Kevin will be attending the United States Air Force Academy to be a part of their football program.
Jaden Patton White.
Jaden will attend East Carolina University.
It is now my privilege to present some special awards to our seniors. The Kelly Automotive Book Award is presented to one student in each grade. The recipients receive a copy of the book, The Theory of Five, which focuses on the importance of finding mentors who can provide the most positive influence and guidance in five important parts of our lives. This award is presented to students who have demonstrated leadership and a strong work ethic in and out of the classroom, serve as role model or mentor for peers, and are active members in all aspects of the Holy Trinity community. Congratulations to Lauren Porter. The National Association of School Principals American Citizenship Award is bestowed on students who participate in school and or community service, show a positive attitude towards classmates, school and community, display an understanding and appreciation of civic responsibility, possess strength of character, and the courage to do what is right. They promote citizenship within their SKU community through their activities. Holy Trinity awards this honor to two students, one male, one female, for each grade level. For the senior class of 2020, congratulations to Javarius Johnson and Liz McKee. Established in 2018, the Campanini Scholarship Award is given to a Holy Trinity senior. Luca and Carlo Campanini attended Holy Trinity from 2010 to 2018. Both were decorated members of the varsity soccer team, as well as recipients of the Peace Award. To be eligible for this scholarship, candidates must be a varsity athlete who excels both on and off the field of play. They must exhibit good sportsmanship, display academic excellence, and strong leadership, as well as dedicated service to school and community. Congratulations to Lauren Gales. The Catherine A. Ford Scholarship Award was established in 2012 to recognize the 25 years of extraordinary service by Catherine A. Ford, head of school, from 1988 to 2013. This award honors a graduating senior who demonstrates strong moral character, academic excellence, leadership skills, and service to school, church, and community. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Jacob Cogchell. Our final award today is the Peace Award. It's a treasured Holy Trinity tradition. Every year, it is awarded to students from each grade level who exhibit the qualities expounded in the school's core values. The students who are selected demonstrate the love of God, self-respect, respect for one's neighbors, and respect for God's creation. They foster honorable and ethical decision-making throughout the community. These students embrace others' uniqueness, encourage a spirit of cooperation, and promote a sense of fair play. Holy Trinity awards this honor to two students, one male, one female, for each grade level every year. I am honored to present this award to the following seniors. Brett Braddock and Kaylee Dunn. It's now time to bid farewell to this class of 2020. Today, we must face the end of something very familiar to you, the end of your high school career. Today, you say goodbye to everything that is familiar, everything that's comfortable, and to the many friends you have come to love. You are moving on, and it is a bit sad. Your hearts may even hurt a little bit. However, I know you're ready. The faculty and staff here at Holy Trinity have poured their knowledge and their love into you for these last years, and together with your parents and family members, they have given you the tools to be successful. Everything from I Care Cat to character education to the Holy Trinity Way has seeped into you to provide you with an inherent sense to know right from wrong and to understand the value of hard work. However, most important of all, we hope you leave here with a strong faith in God and that your life beyond the walls of Holy Trinity will be guided by the one who made you and who knew the number of hairs on your head before you were even born. May you trust in his guidance and always seek his plan for your life, and let God take you to new heights, heights that we can only imagine for you. God bless you, and go forth and make us proud.
Good evening. I'm Brandon Assam, the 2020 Student Government Association co-president. For some of us, our time at Holy Trinity started 15 years ago, making us lifers. And others joined our family later, in elementary school, junior high, or even high school. Regardless of when we started, we are all finishing together as the class of 2020. We want to show our deepest thanks and gratitude to Holy Trinity, our staff, teachers, and administration. We will always remember what you have taught us. We will remember the life lessons we learned along the way, and we will remember all the special moments we shared. To show our thanks, the class of 2020 is purchasing an aeration system to prevent the buildup of excess nutrients and fertilizers that have resulted in the blue-green algae blooms in Lake Catherine. We give this gift in honor of all our teachers, and particularly Mr. Wes Lovelace, for his love of our natural world and his dedication to his students. We hope this gift will secure the long-term health of Lake Catherine and the surrounding ecosystem, and help make our campus even more beautiful for the students who follow us over the years. We would now like to ask all the class of 2020 graduates and our guests to find the glow sticks in your gift bag. Please break them and join us in singing the HTEA alma mater.
Yeah. Please stand, activate your glow sticks, and the alma mater will begin.
Do you want me to stay here? Thank you. You may be seated. Let us pray. O eternal God, bless all schools, colleges, universities, and especially Holy Trinity Episcopal Academy, that they may be lively centers for sound learning, new discovery, and the pursuit of wisdom. And grant that those who teach and those who learn may find you to be the source of all truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, from whom we come and to whom we go, and by whose will the time between coming and going is time to find ourselves and time to find you. We offer thanks for this time of change, for new knowledge and new friendships and new perspectives in our lives. Help us to remember, help us to become, help us to be of use, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please stand and join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. Not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we come to you with grateful hearts as we celebrate the successful completion of high school for these graduates of Holy Trinity Episcopal Academy class of 2020. As they move forward into the challenges and adventures that lie ahead, I call on you to strengthen them and give them peace. Give them eyes that truly see, that see the needs of the world around them and recognize in them your fingerprints and the opportunities you have laid before them. Give them ears that truly hear, that are tuned to your voice and hear your call above the din and disruption of the world. Give them hands that are open, not clenched or grasping, but gentle and generous, and quick to move in service to you and others. Give them hearts that know neither limit nor fatigue, so that they might experience the depth of a life well lived. the deeper places of love and sorrow, passion and pain, hearts that can lie quiet when the world is anxious. Give them souls that are filled with your love. Let them find in and through their relationship with you continual springs of hope and innovation. Tonight, I ask all these things of you, God, as the giver of all good gifts, in the name of the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
You may be seated for the dismissal. All right, I know it's not a good sign at the end of a ceremony for the preacher to get up, but I promise I will be quick. But normally I have the baccalaureate service to give one final thought and charge to the graduating class, and I did want to give one thought. My name is Jared Jones. I'm the chaplain here at Holy Trinity's Upper Campus. I know it's late, and we'll get everyone home soon. But congratulations, class of 2020. I'm so proud of you. Yeah. And as we come to the close, I wanted to give a thought about what comes next. Because now that you've graduated, you begin the rest of your life in pursuit of really one question. Who am I? This is the question of identity. And we're all trying to find an identity in something. And really, identity is just our attempt to answer the question, who am I? Am I okay? Am I enough? Do I matter? And what we do is we go through life trying to scrape together enough things or accolades or status to give a final answer to that question of who am I? I'm a successful businesswoman. I'm a caring father. I'm a good person. I'm an athlete. I'm a 4.0 student. And these are fine as far as they go. And they're great. And they're good. And they're things, noble things to pursue. But the big glaring problem with all of them is that if they are the hook that you try to hang all of your identity on, well, what you find out is that they're all contingent. That if you have achieved them, then they can also be taken from you. And haven't you, the class of 2020, seen how quickly things that seem so consistent and reliable can be taken? So the question that you need to ask yourself as you go off into the world, and the question all of us should ask ourselves, is there an identity that I can find that isn't contingent? Is there anything I can grab hold of that is guaranteed to never let me down? If my identity is success, well then who am I when I meet utter failure? If my identity is that I'm a good person, what do I have when I'm sitting in the back of a police car? If I'm strong, well who am I when I find myself in the midst of an addiction I can't quite get a hold over? Who are you when the world falls apart? And the answer that I want to tell you is just a quick, brief story about Penelope, my 4-year-old daughter. Yeah, you thought you weren't going to have to hear about it anymore, but you're wrong. The other night, we were on a walk, and me and my wife and my kids, and she looked at me and asked a question that I'm sure many of us have asked from time to time. She asked, "Daddy, does Jesus think I'm pretty?" Well, I was a little bit surprised by the question. Well, yeah, of course she does. But then she asked a deeper question, and a question that wasn't as quite as simple. Why? Why does Jesus think I'm pretty? And I was, now at first this seems simple. The answer is because you are pretty. Jesus looks at you and sees a beautiful girl and simply declares you to be beautiful. This is the way the world deals with identity. I am okay because I have achieved something. I am okay because I have something to offer. But if that's all that she has, then she really doesn't have, if that's all that she has, then she has nothing to offer when someday she inevitably doesn't feel pretty. And if all we have is the identities that we construct for ourselves, then it won't be enough when we run into real life. And the more I thought about it, the more I realized why I, her father, think Penelope is pretty. And it has nothing to do with some objective standard of beauty in four-year-olds. In fact, if she were the ugliest kid in the world, I wouldn't care in the least. Why? Why do I think Penelope is pretty? Because she's mine. She's my daughter. And she belongs to me, and there's not a single thing in the world that could ever change that. In class of 2020, what if Jesus works the same way? What if his love for you and your identity in him is not based on anything that you achieve or that you do? Because anything you do or achieve could be taken from you. What if his love for you is simply based on the fact that he has chosen you, that you belong to him? So this is the answer to the identity question that is not contingent on life working out a certain way. It's an untouchable identity and cannot be changed or undone. Who are you? You're his. And nothing will ever change that because he will never let you go. I'm proud of you all and I love you very much. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ says unto all who truly turn to him. Come to me, all of you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will refresh you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to the end that all that believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And hear also what St. Paul says, that this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John says, that if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Would you please stand to sing the grace? Graduates, class of 2020, go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Class of 2020, we now invite you to toss your caps in celebration of your graduation. God bless each of you.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my dragon. Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag you down. Know you're not alone,
trouble.